Okay, great. Thanks for having us here. We talked a little bit yesterday to some of the press. We just had a pretty big announcement this morning. I'll talk a little bit about it, but I want to talk about kind of the overall platform that we had in the marketplace and then a little bit about what our big announcement was. Yeah, it's pretty exciting. Mackenzie, this is my daughter, Mackenzie. She's 9 and a half, she's in third grade. She's a very avid user. She's a very happy user of the product that we have, and I think one of the big advocates, so that's why she's here. She's holding our original Intel powered classmate PC. What we basically have developed since 2007 was a laptop designed specifically for kids. I'm not sure if you guys are familiar with the term netbook, but they're affordable, low-cost laptops, if you will. That are meant for specific purposes. And this happens to be a netbook made specifically for kids. We have a lot of effort at Intel with some social scientists, our ethnographers, and also a lot of us have been involved in the product definition. When we're out in schools, we're talking to students, we're talking to teachers, we're talking to our own kids. This is research that we've done to figure out what's the right thing to do for a kid. What does a kid want when it comes to technology? And it's not just about the technology, which I'll mention in a couple minutes. It's about an entire solution that's in education for kids. But what we've done is we've basically taken this platform and made this small enough, portable enough, and we make it look like this is something for kids. I mean, when I first brought this home, Mackenzie said to me, "Dad, is that for me?" Well, yeah, it is for me. Kids look at these and go, "This isn't my dad's laptop, this isn't my mom's laptop, this is something for me." It fits her size, it's the right size keyboard, it's the right size screen, and oh, by the way, it's not on, so it's not as exciting of a demo, but I can do that with it. Now, I wouldn't want my wonderful daughter that I love so much to touch my laptop for work, but this thing's built for kids to be able to chuck them around, put them in their backpack and forget that they're in their backpack and chuck their backpack on the playground. These are things that are really meant to be durable enough for kids. They're kid-friendly, the design is kid-friendly. And we have a whole ecosystem that we built around this. This is not an Intel product. We don't sell this. We're a chip company. But what we've done is we've developed this and worked with our local partners. We have a network of about almost 40 local OEMs. These are system integrators, folks that sell computer systems and integrate computer systems worldwide. There's 3 in the U.S. And they're selling these into schools. And a couple of them are on retail as well. And these are affordable netbooks that can go into schools. They're deployed, they're serviced, they're supported, so we have that sustainability piece to it. But we also have a network of ecosystem partners. And these ecosystem partners are folks that have content. So we've got companies like McGraw-Hill. We've got software companies like Inspiration Software that does Inspiration. We've got hardware accessory companies like Lego Education, who's announcing their a robotic system for elementary schools. So you guys are doing Mindstorms. This is Mindstorms for elementary kids. It works on classmate PC. We have Pasco Scientific that has sensors that plug into this to do science experiments, temperature sensors, all kinds of sensors. It's something that kids can use in the classroom. Now, we have this in the classroom. Mackenzie's had this for a while. You like it?
I love it.
Well, she's going to get a chance to talk a little bit more about the one that she can't put down. Because what we've done is we've had this in classrooms and we've realized there is some other usage models that we haven't taken advantage of. When kids are writing or drawing, they typically put technology aside. There's a lot of tools for that, but it's not that friendly on a regular laptop. So what we've done is we've done some additional research and we found from our research this concept called micromobility, where kids want to pick up their laptop or their technology, walk around the classroom. They want to go sit in the beanbag chair in the corner of the room with a couple buddies. They want to go outside and do a couple temperature measurements or do a microscope or some kind of experiment in their environment. And while you can do that with this, and it's very portable, there's a little bit missing. When we try to teach them writing or drawing or that kind of an art form, it's tough to do on a PC. So what we've done is taken a look at some of that model. So we've got a model here. It looks kind of like the other one, right? Not the special, but if you go ahead and put it in the tablet mode, Mackenzie, you flip it around, it folds into a little tablet. Now, the cool thing about this is you can walk this around. You can go anywhere you want. But the nice thing is this can be used anywhere. You can walk it around. It's got an accelerometer in it, so as you flip the screen changes. The neat thing about that is it's an open design, so anybody who wants to write some education software that takes advantage of an accelerometer, maybe science or physics, they can actually take advantage of that. It also has a really neat technology called on the touch screen. You can actually use your finger to interact with it. The problem is when kids write, I don't know how many of you have used a tablet before. It's really hard for adults to use tablets. You have to write with the stylus. A lot of times they think your finger or your stylus is a replacement for the mouse. Well, the little red X and the little menus, it's really hard to click. Now imagine a kid trying to do that. So what we've done is two things. One.